The decision by Cabinet to approve the roadmap for the commercialization of the Kiira electric vehicle project builds upon work started at Makerere University to champion value addition in the domestic automotive industry. Ministry of Finance has made the commitment to release funds for this project starting next financial year 2018-2019. The project that will be done in phases will see government release 24 billion shillings for the first phase. Already, government has allocated 100 acres of land to Kiira Motors Corporation in Jinja Industrial Area to start building a manufacturing plant.
So we hope that this iron ore, it's about 260 million metric tons, that we can also develop it to be able to make bodies for the vehicles. Also, you are aware that we have oil and gas. Many of you and many people have been asking, but now if you have electric vehicles, then what will happen to our oil? We should be the ones promoting our oil.
According to the Minister of Science, Technology and Innovation, Dr. Elioda Tumwesije, 85% of the vehicles imported into the country are largely old, used vehicles with an average age of 16 years. The first Ugandan-made cars are expected to be rolled out on the road after 4 years, counting from the next financial year. After cars, buses too will be manufactured.
And hopefully, as I said, by after 4 years, we should be able to have installed capacity to produce 5,000 cars, 5,000 vehicles in 2.5 shifts.
The products that we are looking at bringing on market will be quite competitive with what the competition can offer. Now, when I talk about the competition, then I want to first keep quiet on my pricing so that when I'm ready, the competition has not undercut me, because they're already very established.
Ugandans have been challenged to position themselves if they are to tap into the huge benefits that will come with this project that is expected to give employment to over 940 people.
But we also know that there will be indirect jobs, like in the various stream that I talked about, which would be about 12,000 jobs. So by and large, it will also give us skills. If we get people who are going to be working on this project of vehicles, it means if Toyota opened up an assembly plant or Volkswagen or whatever in the region, then you can also take your skills from here and you go and work in that region. So it also will be used to build skills of Ugandans to make cars, instead of looking at only the simple jobs.
This report was filed by Jaliat Namoya for Urban TV.